Good morning, students. I hope that you all are fit and fine. Okay, so today we are going to start your new chapter, that is chapter 9, and that is reproduction in animals. Okay, so you have already studied about some of the processes, like you have studied about digestion, you studied about circulation, respiration, excretion, and many more processes. So today we will be studying the reproductive system, and you know this is also one of the important processes in our life. And now the come what is reproduction. Okay, so this reproduction we will be studying in this chapter, and this process is very, very important for us, because of this process only there is a continuation of the species generation to generation. And then if you remember, in class 7th you studied the reproduction in plants, and this year we are going to study about reproduction in animals. So you studied that there are two modes of reproduction. One is known as the sexual mode of reproduction, and the other mode is known as the asexual mode of reproduction. So both the modes are present in animals also. So one by one we will be studying about them. Now children, if you observe, you can see your NCERT book, one table is given there, and in that table name of some animals are given, and you have to write their young ones, means their babies, what is the name of their baby. So that table you have to complete. Okay, so let us discuss about that table. That is, first with the in the animal category you can see humans. So what is the name of the young one of the human? That is known as the baby. Then what is the young one of the dog known as? Dog's young one is known as puppy. Then for hen, what is the young one of hen known as? Chick. Then what is the young one of butterfly known as? Larva. Then what is the young one of cow known as? Calf. And for frog it is known as tadpole. So this way different names are given for the young ones of different animals. So I was telling you that in case of plants also there are two types of reproduction, and those two types of reproduction, in the one where the asexual reproduction is there, that in that condition no gametes are required. And then the reproduction which is taken sexually, means sexual reproduction, gametes play very important role. And you know that for sexual reproduction male gametes are required and female gametes are required, because of in the absence of male and female gamete this reproduction could not take place. So let's study, today we will study about the sexual mode of reproduction, and after completing it then we will discuss about the asexual mode of reproduction in animals. Okay, so now let's study about the sexual mode of reproduction in human beings. Okay, so as I told you that in this gametes play very important role, so it means male gametes are required and female gametes are required. So male gametes will be required by the male reproductive organs, and female gamete will gametes we will get from the female reproductive system. Okay, so now we will discuss about the male reproductive organs, then we will discuss about the female reproductive organs. So let's start the sexual reproduction in human beings. Okay, so the sexual reproduction, first of all, modes of reproduction, as I told you, one is the asexual mode and the other is sexual mode of reproduction. Asexual mode of reproduction, okay, and then the sexual mode of reproduction. Now as I told you that in sexual mode of reproduction male gametes are required, those male gametes will be we will get from the male reproductive organs. So male reproductive organs. Okay. So now the question comes, what are the male reproductive organs which produce male gametes? So you know, in case of male reproductive organs, there are three main parts. First part is known as the, there is a pair of testes, okay? And the second is two sperm ducts are there, and then the third part is known as penis, okay? So these three parts are there. So the first part is, we can write a pair of testes. Second is, there is a pair of sperm ducts, or you can say two sperm ducts are there. Two sperm ducts. And the third part is known as penis. Okay, these are the three main parts of male reproductive organs in human beings. Now in this, the testes produces millions of sperms are produced by the testes, and then these sperms are formed and they are released by the human body. So what happens, that the structure of the sperm we should know. These sperms are motile in nature, means they can move from one place to the other place. Okay, so the structure of the sperm has three main parts. Okay, the first part is known as head, and we can draw the diagram. So suppose this is, so this is the head part. Okay, then its second part is the known as the middle piece. So this is the middle piece, and the third part of the sperm is known as the tail. So this third part is known as the tail. So we can draw it is like this. So this way the sperm contains three parts. First is head, the above part is known as head, then middle piece, and then tail. So these sperms are released by the testes, and then after that they move and they reaches to the female gamete. Actually these sperms are the male gametes. Okay, and they seems to be such a big, but actually you know, they are single cell, they have only one cell in it. Okay, so this is about the male reproductive organs. Okay, then comes the second part, that is the female reproductive organs. So did you understood about the male reproductive? So once again let us check, that is male reproductive organs contains a pair of testes, two sperm ducts, and the penis. So testes produces the sperms, and then they are carried out by the sperm ducts, and then they are released by the penis. And this sperms, the structure of the sperm, if you see, it contains head, it contains middle piece, and it contains tail. Okay, now let's come to the next topic, that is the female reproductive organs. Okay, so these female reproductive organs are very important, as they provide the female gametes. Okay, so let's discuss about the female reproductive organs. In case of female reproductive organs, again there are three main important parts. Female reproductive organs. In female reproductive organs, again there are three main important parts. The first part is known as ovary. Yeah. And the second part is known as oviduct, and its other name is fallopian tube. Second part is oviduct, and it is also known as fallopian tube. And the third part is known as the uterus. okay, third part is known as uterus. So these are the three important parts of female reproductive system, okay. So here also you can see ovary is there, ovary will produce ova. Ova is the female gamete and it is also single celled. And then after the production of female, the ova, it is carried out by the oviduct. There are two oviducts, okay. This ovary are also two and these oviducts are also two. Okay, so you can write here ovary, a pair of ovary and a pair of oviduct. And then they, with the help of this oviduct, they reach to the uterus. And uterus is the place where the baby is, baby develops. Okay, so the development of baby takes place in the which part? Uterus. Okay, so these are the three main parts of the female reproductive organs. Okay, so the diagram you can see in your book, we can draw it like, you can draw like this. This is the female reproductive organs, you can draw this side of this. You practice because it is one of the important diagram for your exam, okay. Now here this is the ovary, okay, this is the ovary and this part is known as the oviduct. Okay, ovary is there, then oviduct is there, and then after that this is known as the uterus. Okay, ovary is there, this actually uterus is this part. This part is uterus. Okay, now this way you can see that there are three parts: ovary, oviduct and uterus. Okay, so the function of the ovary is to produce ova, then it is carried by the oviduct and then it reaches to the uterus where the development of the baby takes place. And here ova is also a single cell. Now here you can see that two ovaries are there, this side also one ovary is there, other side also. So what happens in 1 month? Only one ova is released, or egg cell you can say, only one egg cell is released, and then in the next month from the next ovary it will be released. And when it is released, what happens? Then it starts from, moves from here, and it moves from this place, and then it reaches here. So what happens, the next process which is here, that is known as the fertilization. So as I told you that here the ova will be produced and then ova will be released from here and it will start moving from here, and ova is coming from here. And in case if any sperm is present here, any sperm reaches here, this part sperm reaches, then fertilization takes place. So the question can come in your exam that where does the fertilization takes place? Fertilization takes place in the fallopian tube or the oviduct. Okay, how it is taking place? Because sperm is the male gamete and ova is the female gamete. Okay, so you can write sperm male gamete, then ova female gamete. Okay, so when male gamete mixes with the female gamete, so how they mix? They come together and then the nucleus of sperm gets combined with the nucleus of the ova, and then the fertilization takes place. It means the process in which male gametes and female gametes are mixed together, it is known as the fertilization. Okay, and this fertilization process is very important because in that condition only, after that only, the further development will take place. Now, there is one very important question, that this fertilization is of two types. You know, as I told you that in case of human beings, the fertilization is taking place in this, at this place, oviduct. Okay, anywhere it can be, this side or this side, anywhere. And in some of the animals, it takes place outside the body. So this way, there is two type of fertilization. One is known as internal fertilization, like you can see here, that is in the human beings. And the other type of fertilization which takes place outside the female body, that is known as the internal fertilization. Okay, and you know, is known as the external fertilization. And in external fertilization, the ova and the sperm both are present outside. The best example you can take of frog. In case of frog, if you might have observed that during the rainy season, what happens, these frogs lay hundreds of eggs on the ponds or the very slow flowing water. You can observe it in the ponds or in the slow flowing water, some eggs will be there. So what happens, these eggs are released and then frog releases sperms also. And you know, the special thing about frog's eggs is that the egg of the frog do not contain any shell. As you have seen in case of hen, there is a hard shell covering outside. But in case of frog, such type of covering is not there. They are very, very delicate. So that's why when the eggs are released, with that some jelly is also released. So that the eggs remain in contact with each other. So when the sperm just reaches there, and then the fertilization takes place, and that type of fertilization is known as the external fertilization. So this way we can say that internal fertilization takes place in human beings, and you know, in dogs, cats, in mammals, internal fertilization takes place. And in this type of animals, mostly aquatic animals, the fertilization is external. Okay. So this way the fertilization takes place. Then I want to tell you that when the frog releases eggs, they release many eggs. As I told you that in case of humans, in 1 month only one egg will be released. While in case of frog, at one time hundreds of eggs will be released. You know why? This is one of the important questions. It can come in your exam. So what happens, these number of eggs are released because the fertilization is outside the female body. So sometimes what happens, suppose the sperm reaches there, and before that some of the eggs decay, or some of the eggs are the aquatic animals can feed on them, or some can just flow in the very high current, or wind is there, storm is there, due to any reason they can decay. So that's why more number of eggs are required for the fertilization, so that at least few of them get fertilized. So this is one of the important questions. Now students, you may be heard about the test tube babies. Do you know? I think no one knows. So let me tell you that what happens sometimes in the female body, like in the human beings, this oviduct gets blocked due to any reason. It may be due to some injury, or it may be due to any infection. This oviduct is getting blocked. And if the oviduct will be blocked, then sperm will not reach there. And if the sperm will not reach there, then the fertilization will not take place. And as I told you that if fertilization will not take place, further development of the baby will not take place. Okay. So in that condition, what happens, that doctor collects sperms and eggs for the IVF. And they keep it for some time. They fertilize them outside the body. And after fertilization, they keep it for 1 week. And then after that, it is inserted in the female body. And then rest of the development takes place inside the female body. That is uterus part. Okay. So due to this reason, as the fertilization took place outside in the test tube. Test tube is there where the sperms and the ova are mixed together in the presence of some special chemicals, okay, so that they do not get decayed. And then that's why this is known as the test tube babies, and this type of reproduction is known as in vitro fertilization. So that's why IVF it is known as in the short form. So this is about the main processes of the reproduction. So once again, let's summarize what we studied. So first of all, we studied that there are two modes of reproduction. One is sexual mode and the other is asexual mode. Then we studied that there are male reproductive organs for the production of male gametes and female reproductive organs for the production of female gametes. And in male gametes, there are three parts: a pair of testes, a pair of testes is there, a pair of sperm duct is there, and a penis is there. While in case of female reproductive organs, a pair of ovaries is there, then oviduct is there, and then the uterus is there. So this way, male reproductive organ as well as female reproductive organ, they contain three parts. Okay, and the sperms are produced in the testes, and the ova are produced in the ovaries. And then when the fertilization takes place, then after that zygote is formed. You know, one thing is very important here, that after the fertilization, the structure which is formed, that is known as zygote. You should remember zygote, Z-I-G-O-T-E. The question can come, what is a zygote? So you can say that when male and female gamete mix together, then a structure is formed which is known as a zygote. Okay, so this is there. And then after that, I told you there are two types of fertilization. One is internal, which takes place inside the female human body, and the other case where fertilization takes place outside the body. So it can be in humans or animal or dogs or cats, internal fertilization. Then frogs, then birds, etc., and the aquatic animals also, external fertilization takes place, like in starfish also fertilization is external. Now children, as the last topic was about the test tube babies, and you understood that they are not, some people think that they are found in the test tube, but actually they are not found in the test tube. Only the fertilization takes place there, and after that they are inserted in the uterus in the human body, and then rest of the fertilization takes place, and this way the process is completed in 9 months, okay, for in case of human babies. So now next, in the next turn, we will study about after fertilization, when the zygote is formed, then how the development of embryo takes place.